Attention troopers, this is your Imperator, Darren Stein. In the previous video, we were planning to dam this entire lake while getting some iron. And now the dam is complete, giving us a huge reservoir of water to survive droughts. And our scavengers have completely mined all the ruins in this area, giving us hundreds of scraps and the ability to manufacture metal blocks as well. Our industrial complex is up and running, and at this point, we can manufacture every construction material in the game. Which brings us to dynamite. When placed on a ground tile, dynamite can delete one layer of dirt below it, allowing beavers to divert rivers and manipulate the terrain to their liking. Which is how I created this irrigation canal all the way from the lake into the spider dock farm. And I've also started to cultivate cattail and wheat crops, plus the necessary buildings to process them into bread, crackers and pastries. Power generation have also increased up to 7,000 horsepower, which is more than double our current demand. And to store all that excess energy, we will need batteries. This gravity battery can store energy by hoisting up some heavy material and lowering them again when the energy is needed. And the further you can lower the weight, the more energy it can store. Naturally, this means that you need to build this battery pretty high up. But as you can see, you can also dig a trench for the weight to be lowered into, and it will increase the capacity all the same. Now we just need to dig a deeper trench with some dynamite until we reach the bottom of the map. Now that we've reached the bottom of the map, we can't place any more dynamite. So we'll simply repeat the process on the other side. After digging a trench to the bottom of the map, each of these gravity batteries can hold 20,000 horsepower hour of energy. Which means if we round up our energy demand to 4,000 horsepower, one battery alone can sustain our settlement for 5 hours. And we can scale up the arrangements of these batteries to create a battery farm. First, we'll dig two parallel trenches until we reach the bottom of the map. then build the batteries right alongside them with the necessary platforms to support the structure. Since we already connected the batteries to the power network, they will release the stored energy as soon as it's needed. Now we have our first battery farm. Since every battery can hold 20,000 horsepower hour and we have 23 of them in this farm, so in total we can store 460,000 horsepower hour. If we round up our energy demand to 4,000 horsepower, we'll get 115 hours of use. And since beavers work for 16 hours per day, it means that this battery farm can sustain our energy needs for 7 days straight without recharge, which is a lot, but also not that great, since droughts can can last more than 7 days in normal difficulty. I will probably add 20 more batteries in the future to prepare for when our beavers start making golems, excavators, and other power-hungry buildings. This is Devrin Stein signing off.